Je voulais venir à Nice ce matin.
I wanted to come to Nice this morning.
Après avoir tenu un conseil de défense avec le Premier
After
ministre.
After holding a defense council with the Prime Minister and the main secretaries of state involved in order to establish what our response should be. After this horrific attack where an individual got behind the wheel in a lorry and used it to kill people. Why did that happen in Nice? Because it's a well-known city, known throughout the world and one of the most beautiful cities in the world. And why did it take place on Bastille Day? Well, because on Bastille Day we celebrate freedom. So his aim was to strike France and decided to launch this terrorist attack with the various politicians, the Secretary of State, Minister in charge of Social Affairs. We wanted first and foremost to get organized in order to protect the department, the city, and ensure its full protection in case should there be any associates still ready to take action. We're able to counter any such threat on the population. But we also wanted to express our sympathy to the victims, their families. And as I speak, 80 people, 84 people have lost their lives, and about 50 people are in a critical state in hospital. Among those victims are many French citizens, but also a lot of foreign citizens from various continents, and there are a lot of children among the victims, young children who have come to the fireworks with their families to celebrate, to share that joy, and who were struck and the victims of this attack were one man and possibly a group.
Alors, nous avons vu aussi
wanted to
les blessés,
launch
blessés,
this cruel attack
qui,
on our citizens.
Ont surtout des images effroyables.
There are also a lot of injured people
dans la tête,
who still have in mind
dans leur chair,
the horrific scenes
encore davantage
of yesterday evening, and they're still suffering
et puis, il y a même
physically and mentally. And there are people who didn't suffer any physical harm, but who will, throughout their lives, be traumatized after witnessing those horrible scenes. A lot of them told me that they couldn't remember any of what happened last night, but that the only thing they could remember were those broken bodies on the floor, on the ground, before their eyes. And that's why we all need to share this emotion, this difficult time with victims, with their families, and show sympathy to them.
And que nous avons pu une fois encore
once again,
relever parmi les forces
this,
de sécurité toutes mobilisées
the courage of the security forces
pour que ce feu d'artifice puisse être autant qu'il était possible
security forces had
protégé,
done their utmost to make these fireworks as safe as possible for everyone
ici à Nice,
as they had done during the Euro events in Nice recently. The security forces stepped in to neutralize the perpetrator, of course, and I still remember seeing those young policemen take action in order to kill the perpetrator and put an end to the killings. Our security forces are fully committed to this fight. They have been busy in the past few months, of course, after the attacks in November in Paris and Saint-Denis. And I'd like to pay tribute to those forces, because they are the pride of France. And I'm talking about the police, the gendarmerie, the intelligence services, those who carry out the inquiries, those who identify the victims, and of course, the firefighters who have done an extraordinary job when it came to supporting the people involved, the victims, taking them to hospital and stepping in where those victims were also driven to other places, not just hospitals where they had to be supported. I visited myself a hospital here where people rushed in. Doctors were not on duty last night, but who still came in to treat the victims and to save lives. Not everybody could be saved, of course, unfortunately, but I'd like to pay homage to the staff of these hospitals who showed extraordinary commitment. And of course, we've also seen how the voluntary organizations have helped throughout this tragedy, throughout this terrible event, this terrorist attack, which is one more terrorist attack after a whole series of attacks in the past 5 years. This fight will be a long one because we're faced with an enemy who will still strike, all countries, all peoples where freedom is an essential value. And in this context, we need to rely on our forces, our agencies, on the commitment of the whole country. In the past few months, along with the Prime Minister, have taken the necessary decisions to increase the number of workers working for these agencies, and whose number had unfortunately been reduced in the past few years. We're remaining vigilant and we'll continue to support the French people as much as we can. But we have to be strong. The whole world is looking at us. They're expressing their solidarity to France. They have been expressing that solidarity through
their
supportive words.
Un pays capable de surmonter
the whole world knows, however, that we
are
a strong country able to overcome
et nous avons
whatever is thrown at us,
and
we have had to face
au monde
a number of those attacks in the past few months. But I think we're showing a great example to the rest of the world, because we have been able to show
ne pas me laisser
cohesion,
détourner
togetherness.
My
job is to
stick
to the commitment that I took
to
support the French people when it comes to have the right response to the challenges that we have to face with all necessary means. This unity, this cohesion that I'm calling for today here in Nice, so that France can be stronger than those who wish France ill, who want to harm France. But we can defeat them because we're all together.